We live in a world that is modeled in duality or binary opposites. Think about phrases like, it takes two to tango. If it's not black, it's white. If it's not on, it's off. So inevitably, if it's not man, it's woman. This is how the gender binary has come to exist. The concept of gender can be defined as a social construct and social behaviors society tends to assign to a particular sex. From this, it can be gathered that sex is first and foremost a biological construct, while gender is performance. Our existence as human beings continues to prove that things aren't so black and white, though. There exists a multiplicity of realities and experiences. Being non-binary, gender neutral, or genderqueer simply means not subscribing to the gender binary or your biological sex. Do you ever cross-dress or wear unisex clothing and think, it's not that deep? Are you a girl who intentionally doesn't shave or a guy who wears earrings? These could be the makings of a non-binary person. More distinct ways of expressing non-binary gender identity could look like changing your pronouns to they, them, or making it a point to use gender-neutral bathrooms, such as family bathrooms in a mall. Gender simply is what you make it, and there's an entire spectrum as to how people perform it. In the wake of decolonizing, we understand that a lot of the conventional ways of living have been adopted from the West. This applies to gender too. Gender has been universalized as a tool for organizing society. Hence, majority of our societies are patriarchal. But there are other realities in other parts of the world that prove that this isn't the only way to organize society. Author of The Invention of Woman, Oyeronge Oyewumi, asserts that in the Western context, the terms gender and sex are synonymous and interchangeable, and that it is this biologically deterministic approach that has been imposed on post-colonial Africa and other parts of the world. She asserts that gender was invented in Africa. So here's a brief history on alternatives that have existed to gender and the gender binary as an organizing tool. According to Nogo, there existed a flexible institution of women marrying women, or female husbands. The institution has existed in up to 30 pre-colonial African societies, which include the Zulu and Sotho people of South Africa and the Nuer of Sudan, to name a few. This claim highlights that this was a common practice in numerous African societies, meaning that gender was already understood as a social construct separate from biological sex to some degree. In the Yoruba tribe of southwestern Nigeria, gender is not what is used to organize society. Rather, the point of seniority is the modus operandi in this society. Familial relationships are based on age, which is signified in the language, where the word egbon refers to the older sibling and aburo to the younger sibling. In fact, in many African languages, pronouns are not gender specific, but gender neutral. This means that they do not refer to a he or a she. It is here where Oyewumi depicts the distinction between worldview and world sense, in that the Yoruba tribe not only values visual sense, but auditory sense as well. Identifying as non-binary doesn't go without its challenges, since it is still considered a threat to the norm. Some of the challenges include dating. People still tend to the gender binary and want people who present as distinctly masculine or feminine. Another challenge is that people tend to have a fixation on non-binary people's anatomy. Misgendering. This is when people call people outside of their preferred pronouns. This is another way in which the binary is reinforced, whether it is accidental or intentional. There is also the idea that non-binary people go through a transition in the same way a transgender person does. Non-binary people are more recognized now, and in recent times, they are also being documented. So how can you validate or recognize the existence of non-binary people, you ask? Ask people for their pronouns. Put your pronouns in your social media bios. Introduce yourself with your pronouns if you feel it is a safe space. Scope if a space is safe to ask someone for their pronouns, as not everyone is accepting or understanding of this gender identity. If the space is not safe, use their name in place of pronouns when referring to them. And lastly, assume that all people you don't know or aren't familiar with are a they, them, to avoid misgendering altogether.